Ladies and gentlemen, I'm really happy I'm here with you today to participate to this conference. And first of all, I would like to congratulate the organizers for this event, and of course for giving me the opportunity to present the views and the role of the Deputy Ministry of Shipping in the safe, smart, efficient, and environmentally friendly shipping area. Most of you know that I'm a newcomer in the industry. Well, as a newcomer, I would like to express my enthusiasm for being with the Deputy Ministry of Shipping. Cyprus Merchant Shipping is a sector for which we are all proud. It presents an invaluable asset for our country and is bound to play an even more prominent role for the Cyprus economy as a whole. The shipping industry in Cyprus is a sector that operates. The shipping industry in Cyprus is a sector that operates on a global scale. Its size and international importance go far beyond the size of our country. I dare to argue that it's an international shipping power and the renowned maritime center. Combining a sovereign flag and a resident shipping industry with high quality services and standards of safety and security. Our maritime industry, our maritime registry, ranks among the top international fleets. It is the third largest fleet within the European Union. In addition, our country is considered as one of the large third-party ship management centers worldwide. Over the years, Cyprus has been established as a respectful maritime flag and as a base for international shipping operations. And this was achieved to a large extent due to the effective implementation of the internationally applicable standards for safety, security, and environmental protection. The adoption of appropriate national measures was an additional factor. The maritime transportation system is global in nature. It serves world trade by connecting markets in different parts of the world, moving 90% of cargoes and commodities. It benefits from a well-established and comprehensive international regulatory regime for safe and environmentally sound maritime transportation, delivering by the world's cleanest and least polluting service for the mass transport of goods. When it comes to definition of sustainable development, we all recall the definition of the Brundtland Commission that sustainable development is the development that meets the needs of the present generation without compromising the welfare of the future generations and their ability to meet their own needs. No doubt that whatever we do today affects future generations. And it is for this reason that the maritime transportation system must deliver safe, secure, efficient, and reliable transport of goods across the world, while at the same time minimizing pollution, maximizing energy efficiency, and ensuring resource conservation. For a sustainable maritime transportation system to operate smoothly and effectively, of equal importance are the global standards that support the level playing fields across the world, supporting global safety and environmental standards, and addressing technical and operational requirements for ships. Without neglecting, of course, the adequacy in education and training of crews. In this context, A sustainable maritime transportation system requires competent and well-organized administrations cooperating internationally and promoting compliance with global standards. Our Deputy Ministry recognizes the necessity to promote sustainable shipping and is committed to contribute to the improvement of the safety, security, and pollution control and prevention. The maintenance of a high-quality fleet and the effective implementation of internationally applicable standards in these areas is the foundation on which Cyprus builds its reputation as an internationally renowned maritime flag of quality and as an attractive base for international operations. Our aim is to be proactive. We are always trying to be a step ahead, to take all precautionary measures for the prevention of accidents, human injury, or loss of environment or environmental damage. Our ultimate goal is the continuous improvement of the safety standards of the fleet. The Deputy Minister of Shipping is fully in line with all international instruments currently in force, and we continue to set up the necessary implementation tools in order to exercise total and effective control over our merchant fleet. Over recent years, Cyprus was a very active partner within the International Maritime Organization and contributed positively and constructively to their work, particularly in the area of the protection of the environment and the discussions for the adoption of measures contributing towards the reduction of greenhouse gas emissions from ships. This particular issue is extremely important for Cyprus, not only due to the merchant fleet, but also because of the devastating effects the climate change global warming have on the quality of life of people all around the world. We very much welcome the adoption of the initial IMO strategy on reduction of greenhouse gas from ships last Friday. This strategy, together with the already agreed lower sulfur content in marine fuels as from 2000, will necessitate concerted actions and intensive R&D activities aiming at developing new technologies and fuels which will assist the industry to meet the emissions reduction targets. Now, beyond the environmental sphere, the shipping sector operates in a continuously evolving global environment. And inevitably, it's quite volatile. Every year, new challenges and risks emerge. Nowadays, ships use more complex technologies, and this increases the cyber-associated risks. This is really an area where we believe that the industry should focus in order to safeguard shipping from cyber threats and vulnerabilities. We all appreciate that as change accelerates, the future success in shipping depends on developing an integrated environment, digital vision, and ambitions and daring goals. Bearing in mind all these factors, the Deputy Minister of Shipping is adapting to this evolving environment and is in a continuous process to develop web-based applications which will provide the opportunity to the shipping companies as well as the public to carry out several transactions and access to information as well. Our consistent objective is to offer upgraded services to the Cyprus flag users and the resident shipping industry in general. The introduction of the electronic seafarers application system where the seafarers can submit applications for the issue of seafarers' identification and sea service record book is an example of such services. The recognition of certificates of competency issued by the overseas countries is another one. We are also in the process of building a new interactive website, as well as with the digitalization of our records. The highest priority of the international shipping industry remains the safety of life at sea. Therefore, the IMO must further address issues such as seafarers' training, improvements of navigation safety, and the promotion of an effective safety culture. Undeniably, the human element is still a very important factor in shipping. I firmly believe that well-trained and educated seafarers is the key element to address the high standards of safety and security on board ships and the prevention of pollution from ships. Ladies and gentlemen, the challenges for international shipping are numerous and will further intensify due to the increase of the international seaborne trade. What is certain is that people will continue to travel by sea. Seafarers will continue to be employed on board, and the carriage of goods by sea will continue to be an essential element of the world's economy. The growing global population and socioeconomic development necessitates increased volumes in trade by sea. This implies higher degrees of exposure to the perils of the sea and consequently higher risks for accidents or pollution of the environment. The successful prediction, management, and mitigation of these risks are vital for a sustainable shipping sector. I would like to assure the shipping community that Cyprus will continue with determination and devotion to contribute consistently to the efforts for achieving the highest standards of maritime safety and security, as well as efficiency in navigation and the protection of the environment. I would like to thank you once again for your invitation to participate and to wish you a very productive conference and a pleasant stay in Cyprus as well.